we're not only teaching them about Jesus Christ, but we try to teach them about honesty and integrity and values and how to cooperate with one another. Those are all things that are important to them. Boy, you look good tonight. Are you ready to sing? We're ready to listen. We hope this is a blessing to you. It's called The Case of the Missing Christmas. We're going to have a word of prayer before we begin. Our sound technicians have a few things they're working on.
traditional porcelain Christ-child figurine is missing.
Oh, that? Yes, I know.
And you're not upset about it?
Not especially.
But Miss Mary, it's that baby that makes Christmas real.
Oh, goodness, I should hope not.
But isn't it a pious antique?
Hardly.
But doesn't it hold some traditional holiday significance?
Not in the least. Why, that priceless antique, as you call it, isn't even an original. It's just a copy. It was mass produced on an assembly line. Would you believe it was factory made?
Nothing artificial for me. I want everything authentic, right down to the tree. No plastic ornamentals or store-bought incidentals. I'm really sentimental that way. I want a genuine real-life Christmas holiday.
She wants a genuine real-life Christmas holiday.
The tea cakes must be made from scratch. The stuffing for the turkey homemade. The nutmeg must be ground by hand. So the cake has a just-so taste. 'Cause it happens one time a year. I think Christmas ought to be a time we hold dear. Together around the evergreen tree, the cozy fireplace must glow with the friendliest blaze you see. Nothing artificial for me. I want everything authentic, right down to the tree. Plastic ornamentals or store-bought incidentals. I'm really sentimental that way. I want a genuine real-life Christmas holiday.
She wants a genuine real-life Christmas holiday. We want a genuine real-life Christmas holiday.
Oh, good. Please turn out the lights and close the door when you're done. Ta-ta!
Well, I don't care what Miss Marion says. That thing is priceless to me, and I said to keep looking until we find it.
Okay, everything. If you were baby Jesus, where would you be right now?
In Bethlehem. Where else?
Don't try to be funny, Bethany. We have to be serious, or we're never going to find that plastic baby.
Fine porcelain. Imported, fine, factory made porcelain.
Okay, plastic, porcelain. What's the difference?
I believe the difference comes to about $612.56, allowing, of course, for inflation and taxes.
Well, the fact is, it didn't just get up and walk off by itself.
Why not? I had to go all by myself.
Bethany, this isn't a wind-up toy.
You don't wind up my doll either. She runs on 24 AA batteries.
What Christy is trying to say, Bethany, is that the figurine in question is an inanimate object which is not self-revealed.
Thank you. The story you're about to hear is true. More or less, the names have been changed to Merry Christmas.
December 17th, 3:30 p.m. My partner Frank and I have just completed the Persian trip with the booked one at 593 to Persian 81. Call Canyon on at 319, City Ordinance 11, Death of a Christmas Tradition. 3:40 p.m. Frank and I compiled a list of suspects and went out on the streets to investigate.
Hey! 16. I'm afraid this isn't much of a reward.
Well, Ryan, got any more bright ideas?
I forgot. I spent some of my allowance in the art day.
Yeah, I thought some better for my dog.
I have an idea.
Does it run on batteries?
But no. Important to them, said it didn't seem like Christmas.
Nothing artificial for me. Looks like everything's authentic, right down to the tree. But now I'm thinking, maybe is it the holy baby I'm really celebrating this year?
Oh, come, are ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye to Bethlehem.
Jesus stored in a box like any common ordinary.